Ready to open the hood? UseTool for the tutorials.
And for car parts, the right idea is the Mr. Auto app. Easy, fast, and with better prices than on the website.
In order to change the coolant, you need to buy a container of coolant and an anti-leak additive. You will find the recommended products in the video description. To completely change out your coolant, we advise you to start your car and wait several minutes until the engine is hot enough so that the radiator fan starts. This also means that the engine cooling system thermostat is open and thus you'll be able to train the entire system. Turn off your vehicle's ignition, engage the parking brake, pull the hood release, and open the hood. For your safety, we advise you to unplug your battery. To do this, we recommend watching the video How to Change a Battery Peugeot 207 1.4. Open the cap on the coolant tank. In order to carry out the draining and purging of the coolant in your vehicle, we advise you to check the front of the vehicle to carry out specific steps from under the vehicle. Check the front of your vehicle. Set the vehicle on the jack stands. We strongly suggest that you watch the tutorial Jacking Your Vehicle Safely before carrying out this step. Get a can to collect the coolant when it drains out. We show you how to make one of these containers in our video, How to Make a Liquid Collection Container. Using a flathead screwdriver, loosen the holding clip from the coolant hose, which connects directly to the radiator. Then remove it. Be careful. When the hose comes off, you'll get sprayed. Watch out. If you already let the engine heat up, you run the risk of burning yourself. Gloves and long-sleeve clothing are highly recommended. Let the liquid flow out for a few minutes. You can use specific compressed air tools to quickly drain the system. You can also rinse it out thoroughly with water. Put the hose back in place. Screw the clamping clip back on. You can now set your vehicle back on the ground.
All parts used in this tutorial are supplied by our trusted partners. These partners also help us create as many video tutorials as possible. Check them out in the description below.
Now, you have to put the liquid back into the cooling system. You can find the right fluid for your vehicle in the video description. Don't hesitate to fill it over the maximum level. Now you can see the airbox, which should be removed in order to access the drain plug. Using a flathead screwdriver, release the clamping clip holding the airbox. Disconnect the breather pipe. Remove the sensor of the airbox. Next, you need to remove the air intake duct by pressing on both sides of it. Now you can remove the airbox by pointing it upwards and pulling towards you. Open the cooling system air drain screw until liquid flows out of the drain and there are no more air bubbles in the system. Close the drain screw. Then reinstall the various elements. Next, you can readjust the coolant level. Close the fill plug. Reconnect the battery. Start your vehicle and drive it for about 10 minutes, enough time for the thermostat to open and for the coolant to flow all the way through the cooling system. Regularly check the coolant level after you have used your vehicle a few times. If your car often leaks around the radiator and other parts of the system, we advise you to use an anti-leak additive that will quickly fill small holes and leaks in the liquid coolant system. Operation completed.
Hi, it's Theo from UseTool. I hope this video has helped you a lot in your car maintenance. We would be super grateful if you could spread the word so that we can produce even more tutorials. Simply give us a like, a comment, and hit that subscribe button. It really helps us boost the channel and help the whole community. Thanks a lot and have a great one.